So my understanding is that you're calling me at the corporate office because you're trying to decide what to do. And I'm sitting there sort of confused, because at what period of time is ever anyone impoverished or living in poverty a responsibility of you or any of my employees there? You see, what you're proposing is illegal and is also immoral. It is illegal underneath the guise and premise of your job, and it is immoral in the fact that we as a people of America must regard every human being with dignity and honor, regardless of their challenges. You see, we cannot just allow the people who are mentally unwell that we see all the time across America get special privileges, and then we cannot sit there and assign people who are not mentally unwell but are being constantly abused mental health issues. You see, any man's reaction to constant utter harassment and abuse is rage. And the lie you've told yourself is that you think you have the right to call some social worker today, you think you have the right to call some shelter today, and you think you have the right to that man's life in any way. You don't. You have allegedly met this person on behalf of our company, which is sort of true and sort of untrue based on some of your employees. It's sort of true under the fact that you literally might have sold some markers to that individual, but it's untrue under the reality in which you failed to recognize where your rights as an employee to our company begins and ends. And openly, that's the truth. Of all the aspects of American culture, you better fucking understand your job today. You're an hourly worker in our company, and that's all you are today. You are not that man's family. You are not that man's friend. In my gathering of what I'm understanding from you about what you've been saying is that your employees have been illegally attacking that man, that your employees have been illegally putting their hands in his pockets, that your employees have been illegally doing things that are inappropriate on behalf of my company. So let me make this really, really clear, that our company can sue you for the abuse of our employee time, and that our company will do so because we don't need the bad publicity and the bad press of your attitudes of thinking that somebody who calls you on the phone is actually related to that person out there. At no time should your employees ever be using their break time to be smoking in front of our company. And at no time should those children on their break time, which is still a part of our paid hourly wage, be touching someone's property or engaging in any type of physical assault during the day or night in their after hours, because they have solely met that individual through the possibility of being our employees.